I think I already mentioned earlier that unlike some cameramen who graduated from documentary to features, I continue to make documentaries and shorts of various sorts right through my career, right to the end. And in fact, beyond the end of making features, I was still doing some documentaries. And I must have made close to 100 documentaries and shorts in my career, including some very odd ones. Very odd ones, where I was in the office of Merchant Ivory in during the making of the Bostonians once, and the telephone rang, and they said, "This for you." And I said, "But who knows I'm even here, you know?" And I picked up the phone, and this voice said, "My name is Jonathan Power, and I'm making this film about the influence of the mealy bugs on the cassava crop in Africa." And I said, "I beg your pardon? You sure you have the right number?" Well, it turned out that my name had been given to somebody in the lab. The lab had given him my name, and he was about to make this film. He was a journalist called Jonathan Power. He still writes, very interesting. He works for the New York Times, basically, or the Herald Tribune. And he was a very interesting guy, and he knew personally Colonel Obasanjo, who at that time was during one of his stints as Prime Minister, as President of Nigeria. And that's what the film was about, the influence of the mealy bugs on the cassava crop in Africa. And he told us, we started with a shoot in Rome. We did a little shoot in Rome in a conference that was totally boring. I said, I don't want to do that, it's boring. And then we were all due to go to Nigeria, and we were all at the airport waiting for him to come. And it got later and later and later, and he didn't show up. So in the end, I said, well, you know, God knows what's happened to him. We'll have to catch the plane. So we caught the plane. And there was, apart from myself, there was a sound recordist and an assistant and Kate, and that was it. But my assistant was black, and a Cockney Londoner, but he was black. And when we got to Lagos, there didn't seem to be anybody there to meet us. And the reason for that was that they were told to expect a party of four, and what they saw was a party of three, because they looked straight through this black guy. Really, it's the most amazing. And he went through around Nigeria with staring eyes and his mouth open, because he couldn't believe he had no contact. He was a Londoner, you know, he was a Cockney and a Londoner. He had no contact. That sort of life was totally, totally strange to him. That's one of the weirder things I did, but I did a number of weird things.